¿Qué tal, amigos? Gracias por acompañarnos nuevamente en este su programa Vámonos de Pesca. Seguimos en la presa Comedero, seguimos con el señor Steve Parks, pero ahora vamos a hacer una pesca diferente a lo que hicimos en el programa anterior, donde estuvimos pescando con esos spinnerbaits de gran tamaño. Tuvimos buenas capturas, pero ahora vamos a cambiar un poquito la modalidad de esta pesca. Vamos a pescar ahora. What are we going to fish today?
Well, we're going to fish a jig. And the fish come out of the shallow water in the mornings.
Yeah.
They don't move far. A lot of people think, oh, let's go find a jig bite. No, the jig bite's not far. If you're catching them shallow with it, same place, just go a little bit deeper.
Okay.
And I found that when we're catching spinnerbait fish in the morning, right now, in the middle of the day or when the sun comes up, they go deeper and they're going to about 18 foot, anywhere from 15 to 20 foot in the bottom of the trees, under the sombra.
Okay.
So they have to have the roof over their head and they go a little bit deeper. And the tilapia are going deeper too, so the bass go down and they eat the tilapia on the bottom.
So we're going to flip deep submerged, submerged brushes, right?
Yes, we can't see the trees.
Okay.
We can see them on our electronics.
Okay.
And we see the trees and we flip into the trees, let the jig go through the limbs all the way to the bottom. And we bounce it off the bottom, bring it through the tree a little bit, just top over the limb, and then drop it again and let it go all the way to the bottom because the fish are on the bottom, not up in the limbs.
Great. That's a good thing because most of the people think that if you can't see the trees, that doesn't work. And that's wrong because sometimes it's better to fish the trees that you can see.
That you can't see.
Yes.
Yes, sometimes it's much better to do that.
And which
sure.
kind of jig are you going to use?
This is the Oldham. This is the Oldham 1 ounce flipping jig. And if you'll notice, that 1 ounce head, what it's doing is get us into the deeper water faster. Too many times, you know, when we're fishing shallow water with jigs, we can use 1/2 ounce, 3/8, sometimes quarter in very shallow. But since we're deep and we've got some wind, we want this 1 ounce jig so that it goes all the way to the bottom a little bit easier. And we're also putting the Rage Crawl trailer on the back. And we're dipping it in chartreuse, heavy chartreuse, because these fish like the chartreuse.
Okay, we can use the different colors of on the Rage Crawl.
Yes.
But we always dip on the chartreuse dye.
Yes, chartreuse dye. I found the bite just recently. They like a lot of chartreuse.
Okay.
So I just make the Rage Crawl a lot of chartreuse.
Okay, and which color we are using on the jig?
This the jig is tilapia. This is the tilapia colored jig.
Okay.
And of course the fish here are eating a lot of tilapia, so we'll match that. Okay.
Perfect. So sometimes the people think that a jig needs to be a crawl pattern or a crawl color.
Yes.
But sometimes it's not
sometimes
necessary.
That's right. It's not necessary to always match the color of a crawl. Instead, sometimes you want to match the color of a bait fish.
Okay.
And this very much simulates what the tilapia, the tilapia look like.
Yes.
These are a lot of the same colors.
Yes.
And Terry Odom made this color many years ago when we were fishing Falcon and Amistad, where we have a lot of tilapia. And so he made this color specifically for that. And then of course we find out it works all over Mexico very well.
Every lake that has tilapia will work.
This is my favorite color jig. I'll use two color jigs mostly all the time. Tilapia and Falcon Lake Crawl.
Yeah, that's
those two colors are my favorite colors ever.
Okay, and about the fishing stuff, what, for example, I will use a flipping rod.
Yes.
That is a loose custom, it's a Magnum heavy color rod.
Mm-hmm.
That is 7.6 heavy.
Mm-hmm.
I will want to use a 60-pound test line. On
yes, the perfect,
beaches.
Perfect.
And I will use a loose reel that is a Tournament Pro.
Perfect.
And that is 8.321 in radio.
The better, the faster, the better.
Yes. But what are you going to use on your rod and reel?
I'm using the same. I'm using a loose.
The new line of the custom.
Right? Yes. This is the same jig, same color. And I'm using this new custom Super Duty rod. It's a heavy action. So I use 7-11 heavy action with a fast tip. And this is also the new Super Duty reel. It's a wide spool. I like the wide spool, a little more line. But I use this for a lot of things. But flipping is perfect with
this
rod.
Because it's a strong reel. You don't have any problem. You don't need to worry about your gears on the reel, because
right.
You can pull harder and you don't have any problem. Because
yes.
It's hard.
Yes. In fact, Luz, I've been talking to Luz for several years. Of course, a lot of the pros who work with Luz, we were saying we want the perfect reel for everything. For spinnerbaits, for crankbaits, for flipping, and a super strong reel for flipping. And this is the strongest, best reel I've ever used.
Okay, this is 8.0 heat radio.
That's right, that's it.
Okay, so we need the...
also braided line.
Braided line.
In this water, in these trees, flipping these jigs down in these big hardwoods, we need braided line, for sure. You don't want to even think about using fluoro.
No. Yeah. It's not a good idea to use fluoro in this kind of cover, because as you say, the deeper the trees are submerged under the surface, 18 foot deep, and you set the hook and need to bring the fish faster from the trees. Okay?
That's right.
And with fluoro, it's not possible.
That's right.
So let's try to catch some big ones.
Let's go do it. I'm ready.
Okay, perfect. Vamos a empezar a tirar en esta en las mismas zonas que estuvimos pescando con spinnerbaits anteriormente, pero ahora vamos a pescar un poquito más profundo a ver qué tal nos va. Acompáñenos, por favor.
There we go. Come on, come on. That's a big one. Yeah. That's a big one. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Hold it. Oh! Hold it. Oh! No!
It's just about the time.
It's just about the time.
I think I don't catch the fish. He caught me.
I think he worked you over. Good fish, Junior. Yes. Good fish, Edgar Junior.
Yes. The fish is really, really strong.
Yeah, they're very strong.
Yes.
We were fishing spinnerbaits earlier this morning.
Yes.
And then the fish moved out, and so we started fishing with a jig. Right now we're using the Oldham 1 ounce flipping jig, and it's in tilapia color. The tilapia is probably the best color. Of course, these fish eat a lot of tilapia. So good catch, my friend.
Thank you.
Good catch. We put a rage crawl trailer. Summer crawl, we're dipping it in chartreuse because they like a lot of chartreuse.
Yes.
So we just take the summer crawl trailer and dip it in some chartreuse dye and get it real chartreuse. Good fish, good fish.
Good
okay.
Fish. So can you explain to the people why?
Let me put the fish in the water, see?
Please.
Come here, baby. Adios. Gracias.
Can you explain to our friends why we turn from a spinnerbait to flipping jig?
Sure, early in the morning, the fish are up, and they're up shallow feeding. And then what happens, a lot of people think, well, the fish have no more spinnerbait, let's go find a flipping bait. Most of the time, where your spinnerbait bite was, you don't have to go far because the fish go from shallow to deep. And right now, the fish are in 18 foot. This morning, they were in 9 foot and 8 foot bushes. And then and the sun comes up, they go a little bit deeper, and they rest down in the trees so that they have a roof over their head for the sun.
Okay, so that's the reason, that's what we do today. We fish in the same area, shallow water, and then
just move a little deeper.
As the sun comes up,
yes,
we just move to deeper water.
That's right.
That's
right.
Uh-huh. Okay, para que lo tomen en cuenta, amigos, muchas veces
Los pescados ahí los tienes. Pescaste en la mañana esa zona donde estaban comiendo ahí. Pero si encuentras una zona que tenga las condiciones adecuadas para que ahí estén la mayor parte del día, solo es cuestión de ponerle atención a tus zonas de pesca y a qué es lo que está haciendo el pescado. Entonces los pescas en las zonas bajas y solamente cuando el sol sube, tú solamente te mueves a agua más profunda y muchas veces ahí están. O sea, todo el día vas a estar pescando en tu misma zona, pero en diferentes profundidades.
Come on. This is a good one. Huh? Yes! Oh. Come on! Oh. Yeah. Lake Comodoro. Huh?
And where we are?
Lake Comodoro, Ron Speed Junior Adventures, right there.
Okay.
A good flipping fish right there.
And
good job.
Okay.
So,
Steve.
Yeah.
I know you've been working with Drone Speed for years. But
yes.
Tell to the people, what is the difference between Drone Speed and the other lots?
Drone Speed Adventures is the most professional. They also have the best equipment. Yes. They also have pros who come here often. Myself, Terry Odom, Denny Breyer, Kurt Dove will be here next week. Or he'll be here in the next few days. And go! Oh. That's what I'm talking about. But what we get to do is we get to come down here and not only have the fishing trip of our lifetime catching the biggest fish ever,
yes,
but we also get to help find the fish. So we enjoy this a lot,
a lot.
And so it's very helpful for Ron, but at the same time, we help the other people find fish as well. So. It's a wonderful opportunity to come here. Ron's got a professional group, very professional, great people. The staff, the service, everything with his group is perfect.
Great and, food.
Yes, great food. I mean, absolutely great food.
Oh, yes. Two times the same fish.
But it's a great place. I mean, yes, it can't get any better than this.
Yes, I know. The great boats. We have great boats, great guides, great people.
And great fish.
And great fish.
The fishing here is the best in the world.
Yes.
For a fact. There's not a better lake in the world for big fish than Lake Comodoro. Yeah.
You can catch
big just fish like that. Is. Huh? Just like that. Huh? Just like that one.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Well, now, how's that? Bring him up here. Come on.
Oh. Oh.
Big fish like this. I mean, while we're sitting here talking, you know?
Mm-hmm. We are not just talking. We are trying to catch these big fish. Look at that.
Good job.
Yes. Así que ya ven, amigos.
And we're catching them on the good old 1 ounce Odom jig with a Rage Crawl trailer.
And tilapia.
Tilapia color, yeah.
The bass in here and in almost all the lakes, they love the tilapia.
Yes, they love tilapia. Mm. And so what we're doing is kind of matching that color.
Yes.
And these fish eat it like it's candy.
Yeah. Ya ver, amigos, entonces no lo ven tantito. Ya vieron la calidad del servicio que hay aquí en Rostis Junior, la calidad de los guías, de las lanchas, de las instalaciones, la comida, ni se diga. Pero sobre todo, y lo más importante, mira nada más. Y esto mientras platicamos.
Oh, oh. It's a big one. It's grande.
Well, we found the fish now.
Here. Over here now.
Oh. Así que no lo duden tantito, vengan a darse una divertida, la pesca de su vida como la que estamos teniendo Steve y yo aquí en esta grandiosa presa. Aquí están los teléfonos en pantalla y no lo duden tantito, vengan a Ron Speed Junior Adventures. Tienen instalaciones aquí en la presa Comedero, tienen instalaciones en Picachos, tienen instalaciones en El Salto, todas con un excelente servicio y con una excelente pesca. Entonces, puedes incluso armar tu tour con tu grupo de amigos, pueden ir a visitar dos o tres presas, si quieren, todas las presas las pueden visitar, si quieren ir específicamente a una, entonces tienen la opción de que si llegara a no estar
tan buena la pesca como esperabas, pues te pueden mover a otra presa. O sea, no hay ningún problema por eso. Mira, aquí están las lobinas.
Yeah. Another one.
Another one. They are here.
They are here.
Y apenas tenemos unos cuantos minutos que empezamos a pescar en esta zona. Look at that.
Comodoro. Thank you, Ron Spain.
Now I think I'm in love with this.
Yes, lake. It's the best lake in the world. I told you.
Yes.
I told you. You come that. Down here, it's the best lake in the world.
Vamos a tratar de seguir pescando estas excelentes lobinas que estamos agarrando aquí en la presa Comedero, obviamente en Ron Speed Jr. Adventures.
Tony Black. I'm from Virginia, Manassas, Virginia. This is my second trip here. Mostly I came down with the group last year, and everything I heard is Ron Speed's adventure, and it is an adventure, but they take care of you from start to finish, from the time you leave home to the time you get here. All the accommodations, food, they've just been doing it for years. They've been in business forever. They know what they're doing, and they take care of you. At Comodoro, we went to El Salto last year, but I like Comodoro because of the remoteness. And so when you're on the lake, you pretty much have the lake to yourself. So this morning, me and my brother-in-law, Eddie Mullins, fished for 5 hours and never saw another boat. But we caught 50 fish, so it was like we had the whole lake to ourselves. So, and of course, with Comodoro, you always have the chance to catch a giant fish. If you're looking for an adventure and something out of the way, it's a true adventure. You're out there on the lake by yourself. You feel like you're fishing water that's never been touched. So it's a trip. If you're going to do it, it could be a once-in-a-lifetime trip. I said that last year, but I'm back again. But you need to go ahead and just bite the bullet and do it.
Oh. Come on, this is a good one. This is a good one. Good. Yeah. Get ready.
Yes, I'm ready.
Oh, ooh, another good one. Oh. Thank you, my friend. Here.
Oh,
got it.
These fish. Those fish are stronger.
They're strong fish.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, baby.
This is crazy, man.
Are you having fun yet?
Yeah.
Man, this is great, isn't it?
They are all the same ways.
Yes. How does it get better than this? It don't. Come down to Ron Speed. Have a good time. That's all I can tell you.
Whoa. Ya no te dan chance ni de cambiar tu, ni arreglar tu jig, ni nada. Apenas estás dejando tu señuelo listo y ya tienes una captura. Ya sea tú o tu compañero. Pues esto, la verdad, les voy a ser sinceros, cuando me platicaban de esta presa y que decían que una de las mejores presas del mundo y de las mejores presas de México, pues digo, la verdad es que lo dudas hasta que no estás aquí. Mira, aquí está la prueba.
In the brush. In the brush. Come
oh,
on,
man. Oh.
There it's out.
Yeah.
Big fish.
Oh, man, this is crazy.
Oh.
Yo creo que pescas como esta, pocas presas las tienen en la actualidad y esta es una de ellas, mira. Buenas lobinas, ya hemos sacado varias lobinas de alrededor de 7, 8 libras, que como te digo, pues yo creo que no hay presa así que te dé tantas lobinas de ese tamaño en tan poco tiempo. Digo, apenas tenemos el día de hoy aquí pescando y es una locura esta presa, la verdad, estoy más que sorprendido con la calidad de pesca que hay aquí.
Oh, come on, come on. Huh? Oh, yeah. Good fish. Oh, here, you need help, here.
Mm.
Look at that fish.
Oh, man. That's a good one there. Come here, baby.
Oh, man.
What do you think about Commodore now, brother?
This lake is awesome. Awesome lake.
Oh, man. Beautiful.
Yes, for sure.
Beautiful fish. Beautiful. All right, my love. Thank you very much. All right, my love.
And we're still fishing with the same jig.
Yes.
Tilapia color.
Yes.
Race crawl on the trailer.
Mm-hmm.
Warm and red with a chartreuse dye.
Chartreuse dye.
And the pictures.
On the back of the jig, there's a screw lock. Odom invented the screw lock many years ago, Terry Odom, with Odom Jigs. And he invented the screw lock. And instead of a barb or keeper for on the back, you screw the bait up there on the back and it stays on there much longer.
Yes, after that good fish, the trailer
is still
stays
there
in the same place.
Perfect.
Until? Okay.
It's perfect.
And this help you a lot with the trailers. Incluso le agregué una pequeña sonaja. Digo, prefería agregarla aquí atrás, donde se esconde entre las tenazas del langostino, y así de esa forma cuando viene pegando en las ramas lo puedes escuchar. De hecho, aquí lo pueden escuchar ustedes el sonido, que a lo mejor aquí afuera del agua no es mucho lo que suena, pero ya abajo sabemos todos que el ruido pues es mucho mucho mayor, o viaja más distancia, y de esa forma pues aparte te pueden identificar más rápido tu jig, o al menos con el ruido llama la atención de la lobina y lo ya ven el color y toda la acción del jig. Y de esa forma, pues, puedes incrementar tus capturas.
I got it. Oh, that's a good one. Look at that. Look at that. Woo! Way to go, Junior. Good job.
Oh! What happened?
Maybe you should let him play, but that was a big fish, man.
Yes.
A big one.
Yeah, that was a big
one. Whoa! That was a big fish.
Now, the fish wins.
The fish wins.
Bueno. Bueno, sabemos que aquí están los animales. Están animales de muy buen tamaño. Esperamos ahorita sacar la golona del día. Recuerden que estamos en la presa Comedero, en el estado de Sinaloa. Aquí cerca del municipio de Cosalá. Es un municipio hermoso, la verdad. Estuvimos ahí con gente de turismo, con la alcaldesa también, y la verdad es un pueblo muy, muy bonito, tiene muchas actividades. Y recuerden que estamos en el campo de Ron Speed Junior Adventures. Aquí están los teléfonos en pantalla, aquí están los datos para que usted contacte aquí a la gente de Ron Speed Junior Adventures y venga a tener la pesca de su vida como la estamos teniendo nosotros aquí en esta mañana. Digo, apenas estamos llegando a mediodía y llevamos un número impresionante de capturas.
Así que no lo duden ni tantito y vengas a sacar estos grandes lobines aquí en la presa Comedero en Ron Speed Jr. Adventure.
Whoa, baby!
What a double!
Oh, man.
Oh, man!
We let them rest a little bit.
Yeah, and who knows? There they go. Good job.
Yeah, that's awesome.
All right. Here you go. Okay, ready? There you go, baby. Oh, that was fun. How about that for a double, buddy?
Yeah, another good double. And what happened here, Steve? About the wind change.
Yeah, what happens, the wind change earlier was coming from opposite direction, coming out of the north, and the fish were hot.
Yes.
And then after the fish got, the wind changed out of the south, then all of a sudden the fish cooled off, didn't want to bite. So we let the wind change last for about 1 hour. And then come back, boom, 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 they're here. So it's just another good reason. When you get a wind change and the fish quit biting, don't forget the spot. Let the wind have a change for about 1 hour, come back and check, and I promise you those fish will probably be back for you.
Yeah, because the fish is still there.
Yeah.
Just the condition
change. They just said, I don't want to eat.
they have a change of the conditions, and
yeah,
we need to stay a little bit there.
That's right.
On the same condition for a while, and that's it. We caught it.
It worked good. And another thing in these trees, fishing, you know, casting in these deep trees is not so smart.
No.
Maybe only flipping, let it go down to the bottom, through the limbs, bounce it a couple of times, drop it back down, bounce it over a limb, let it go back down, is the smartest thing to do. You can land the fish this way.
Yes.
Otherwise, you're gonna hang up and break them off.
Yeah, because for example, if we make a cast like 20 yards or so, if we catch a fish or get a bite on that distance,
yeah,
there's too many
trees to go through
on the way. Yes.
Instead, we come straight up out of that tree and we have a good chance of landing the fish.
Yes. Sí, aquí lo que estamos haciendo es vemos los árboles en el sonar a no sé 5 o 10 yardas de la lancha de donde estamos pescando. Y solamente le aventamos el señuelo, como si estuvieras pichando a un árbol que ves regularmente afuera del agua. Pero pues aquí la diferencia es que no lo estamos viendo en el agua, lo estamos viendo en los electrónicos. Vemos los pescados, sabemos que ahí están y ya tratamos de no mover el troleador para no hacer ruido, no pegarle a las ramas del árbol. Y ya con esa forma sacamos los animales de abajo de los árboles. Es algo, pues se podría decir que no estamos acostumbrados a hacer. Porque como les decía, siempre hacemos o tiramos a la cobertura que vemos, no a la que estamos viendo en los electrónicos abajo del agua, pero regularmente es la cobertura que nadie molesta, entonces tienen más oportunidad de sacar animales. Yo creo que ahorita de un árbol le hemos sacado 4 o 5 animales, así uno tras otro, pero eso se debe a que es una cobertura que regularmente nadie molesta.
Perfect example of what I'm talking about the fish go shallow, all right, when they're shallow in the spinnerbait bite and then they're deeper on the jig, is we were fishing here
This is where we fish for spinnerbaits up in those shallow bushes. Yes. And then now with the jig, we're in 18 to 20 foot right here. And the same fish that were feeding all in the shallows early are now feeding down here in the deeper trees where they're underneath the trees. They have a they have some sombra. So it's much easier for us to instead of just go across the lake somewhere else when you're catching big fish, stay in the same area. Because those fish that were feeding shallow in the morning are going to be feeding right out here. There, during the middle of the day when there's a lot of sun.
No ocupamos irnos tan lejos, como lo dijo Steve. Exactamente la misma zona que estuvimos pescando con spinnerbait, ahora está jalando con los jigs. Nada más es cuestión de encontrar una buena zona de pesca, un área que tenga estas características, que tenga buena cobertura en el bajo y que tenga la misma cobertura en agua más profunda, y ahí van a estar los pescados todo el día. No necesitan moverse o irse a otro lado, ahí van a estar siempre, van a vivir, ahí van a comer, ahí van a desovar, van a hacer todo en la misma zona.
Oh yeah! Oh yeah! Oh, that's a big one. Look at the size of that. Look at that. Huh? Look at that, darling.
Oh, kaboom!
Oh, man. Look at that. Fine. That is great.
Look at this. It's really,
really a football, man.
Yeah, it's like a football.
Beautiful fish, aren't they? You know, so, that's what you look for when you come to Comodoro.
Yeah.
Is fish, big, fat fish
Let's show the people what is the average speed.
Yeah.
Here. Para que den se tengan una idea de cuál es la. Son lobinas de 6 libras, es el promedio que estamos manejando, o sea que hemos estado sacando el día de hoy. Entonces yo creo que es un promedio que está excelente, o sea no son las lobinas grandes de aquí de Comedero, son las lobinas promedio. Entonces para que se den una idea y se dejen venir para acá, para la presa Comedero, aquí a Ron Speed Junior Adventures.
Look at that. Oh, I got you. That's a good.
Man.
Go, buddy.
This lake is awesome.
Awesome, isn't it?
Awesome.
Everywhere we go, we find big quality fish.
Yes. Oh,
you
man.
You know, we catch a couple of small ones and a big one.
I will talk with Ron Speed if he needs somebody who works in the lodge.
Yeah.
I will stay here.
You're
for
going
long.
To yes. Go to work for Ron. Yes, I think that's a good idea. I think that's a great idea.
Oh, that's a great.
And that Oldham jig, you know, the hook in this, it's so strong.
Yes.
You know, if you bend the hook, you bend it back. But it's hard to bend the hook with this.
Yes, we stay. We try with the same jig all day long.
Thank you, darling.
We stay here all day long, trying the same jig.
The same jig.
We never change the jig. We never lose the jig. And the hook, it's like new. We hung up in
and
the big
how
tree.
And look at the point. The point
yes,
always
it's always sharp. And we hung up a lot of times and never bends the hook.
No.
That's a good quality jig.
The best.
Never in the paint never get off.
That's
the skirt
right.
is like new.
Awesome. Great jig.
Yes. Well, Steve, bad news.
Well, bad news.
Yeah.
No, it's a good jig.
No, it's perfect.
Yeah.
But the bad news is that we need to go.
We need to go already?
Yeah.
Oh.
Time is over.
Time is over. Okay.
But we can still fishing. Okay. Just the show is over.
Oh, okay.
Thank you for being with us again.
thank
you so much. It's an honor for us always.
Junior,
good friend.
This is the most fun to come, you know, to come and fish with you and to have invite you to Ron Speed Junior Adventures to Comodoro, the greatest lake in the entire world. I've been telling you about it, and now you've got to witness it.
Yes.
And see just and how great it is.
I really appreciate your invitation from you and from Ron to make some shows here. And I'm in love with this lake now.
Yes.
I don't want to go.
I don't blame you because I've been in love with it for many years.
Okay.
And when Ron started fishing down here and he invited me to go, he says, hey, I want you to go with me and let's check the lake out. And I came down here and I went, oh, man, I want to be a Mexican man again and live down here for the rest of my life.
Yeah, this is a great lake.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
It's beautiful. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Steve.
I enjoyed having you.
Me too. Bueno, amigos, el tiempo se nos acabó. Esperamos que hayan disfrutado este programa donde tuvimos muy buenas capturas y bastantes capturas. Ya vieron una técnica, pues se podría decir que nueva, porque nunca la habíamos mostrado aquí en el programa, que es, aparte de que es algo que ya habíamos hecho, no lo habíamos hecho en este tipo de circunstancias, que era pichar árboles hondos que no vemos, que encontramos con los electrónicos y que, pues digo, es muy difícil sacar esas lobinas de ahí debajo, pero con un buen equipo, armando bien todo tu set, tanto del señuelo, línea, caña y tu carrete, no debes de tener problemas. Entonces, los esperamos en la próxima emisión de su programa Vámonos de Pesca y recuerden, vénganse a Ron Speed Junior Adventures y van a pasar una pesca excelente. Nos vemos en la próxima.